Now, as I said, we have operating activities. What are operating activities? Inflows and outflows related to production of income from continuing operations. So it says all transactions that are not investing or financing are what? Operating. So everything kind of falls into this category if it's not investing or financing, which are very carefully defined. So for example, collections on sales from customers. So as you make a sale, we'll do lots of journal entries. I'm going to debit cash, credit, sales. So that would be collection from, right, sales. Or let's say I collect an account receivable. So I might have an account receivable here. I'm setting it up. Then later I collect it, debit cash, credit, AR. So collections on sales from customers, payments for cost of goods sold and SG&A, interest received and paid. Circle that, interest received, interest paid. So interest received, interest paid is what? Operating under GAAP. It's going to be different under IFRS, so that's important. But for now, let's just study GAAP. Dividends received are also operating because most companies buy stocks, bonds, and so on as a normal part of operations with their extra cash. They're just putting the cash somewhere to make money. Acquisition or disposal of trading securities. Payments for taxes. Taxes, normal part of business, operating activity. Payments for taxes. All other receipts and disbursements that do not stem from investing or financing are also operating. So as we go through, we're going to be doing a lot of journal entries. And basically, if you debit cash, that's a cash inflow, a source. If you debit, let's say you have some kind of expense and we credited cash, that would be an outflow, cash going out. So a statement of cash flows, you know, normally we're doing accrual accounting. Here we're looking, let's take accrual and go back to cash. So we're going to be doing some reconciling between accrual and cash because we got to figure out, okay, how much of this transaction was actually cash? Because maybe there was interest expense, but it wasn't all cash because some was amortization of bond discount or premium. We have depreciation expense, but it wasn't cash because it was accumulated amortization. So that's where we have to kind of go through and see what the journal entries were to kind of figure them out. Now, FASB very carefully defines investing activities and financing activities. Okay. Now, investing activities, you can think of this. Don't give me any lip. Lip. All right. So when I talk about lip, what does that mean? That is going to be things like loans, investments, and investments like property, plant, and equipment, investing in yourself. So when we talk about this, PP&E, or fixed assets, or intangibles, that would be investing. So think of investing as you're investing in the company. You're making an investment in the company, or you're making an investment outside the company, buying securities, but you're still investing some money. It says investing, principal collections or loans made by the entity, but remember, interest and dividends are what? Operating. Acquisition or disposal of available for sale or held to maturity, those would be investments. Acquisition or disposal of property, plant, and equipment and intangibles, so that's acquiring, so you're investing in yourself. All right, so all of those would be considered an investing activity, an investing activity. So for example, when you buy a piece of equipment, you'll see the journal entry there, debit, PP&E, credit, cash. Notice cash went out, that's a credit, that's a use, that's an outflow of cash, cash went out. But what kind of activity? It would go under the investing activity category. If I bought an investment, debit investment, credit, cash, outflow, cash, investing. When you sell the investment, then I have an inflow of cash from the sale, that would be inflow. So that's why we talk about sources and uses, inflows and outflows, because that's what we're looking at. We're trying to see where the money came from, where the money went to, as far as acquiring it, and what is that activity. So remember, don't give me any what? Lip. Loans, investments, property, plant, equipment, and tangibles. All right, financing activities. What is it? How do you finance the company? How do you get money into the company? How about issuing notes payable, bonds payable, common stock, preferred stock, right? All of those would be ways to finance the company. So when we talk about a financing activity, we're talking about how do you get money into the company? How do you get money in? By financing. So you're borrowing money, notes payable, you're issuing bonds, you're issuing common stock, preferred stock, maybe additional paid in capital. Those would all be considered financing activities. Issuing debt, issuing equity. Now if you look in your notes, it says, proceeds from issuing or payments for retiring bonds, because interest expense is operating. Issuance or reacquisition of treasury stock would be financing. Borrowing or repaying a loan. Circle the next one, dividends paid. Dividends paid, this is important. So dividends paid, that would be, right, generally you're gonna credit cash and then cash goes out. So dividend expense and cash. Notice that is a financing activity. Wait a sec, I'm confused. Interest received, interest paid, operating. Dividends received is operating. Dividends paid is considered a distribution to the owners, therefore it's considered a financing activity. So again, it's important to understand, and that is a distribution to the owners, that is a financing activity.